The 38-year-old Matthew Akoyame was said to have been gruesomely murdered at his Okomu Oil place of work by unknown persons. The wife, mother and three children have been crying for justice as they allege that the deceased was unjustly killed and some top persons are trying to sweep the matter under the carpet. This, according to the legal practitioner Judge Ohioma, will be resisted and that all legal avenues will be exploited to ensure the killers are apprehended. He said the insinuation in some quarters that the deceased was not a staff of Okomu Oil was laughable as it was a design plan by some persons to bury the issue. The legal practitioner who brought out some evidences that shows that the deceased has always been a staff of Okomu Oil wondered why family members are not being carried along during investigation, a sign that suggests that something might be fishy.
After we discovered them, our pains, our grounds, our apprehension, in the way or manner, the company went about this matter. The company without recourse to the police took the cops to their own mortuary, a mortuary and a hospital that is not government owned, and dropped the diseased lifeless body on the ground. Ever since, the company have not dealt with it. To pay visits to the family of the deceased.
The wife of the deceased, Osayunle Akinyame, also corroborated the submission of the legal practitioner regarding to the death of his husband.
When they transferred the case on the 18th, we were thinking that investigation would just commence immediately. Maybe they will arrest more people because they told us that the people they arrested, so the police would have brought them several people. They brought them to your police station. Up till now, police have not made any arrest on their own. So the police have brought those several people to the police. I'm praying for justice, please, because I cannot just start saying them more now.
In an earlier report, management of Okomu Oye has said it will issue statement on their own side of the story soon. Efosa Uwangwe reporting.